अस्सलाम वालेकुम रहमतुल्लाहि व बरकातुहू। टुडे वी शैल टेक द रिवीजन ऑफ द चैप्टर एयर अराउंड अस। दिस चैप्टर इज कमिंग इन योर यूनिट टेस्ट, सो गो थ्रू दिस चैप्टर वेरी केयरफुली, स्टडी प्रॉपरली एंड गिव योर टेस्ट ऑनेस्टली एंड सीरियसली ऑल्सो। डोंट ट्राई टू कॉपी आंसर्स फ्रॉम योर नोटबुक और यू जस्ट पेस्ट द पिक्चर फ्रॉम योर नोटबुक, प्लीज प्लीज डोंट डू दैट। Now let us revise the chapter air. You know that air is very important for the survival of living beings. We cannot live without air. Though we can live without water or food for few days, but without air it is difficult to live. We cannot see or smell air, but we can feel air. When it blows, when the air blows slowly, it is called a gentle breeze or breeze, and when it is a heavy blow, it is called a wind. So air is present all around us. Now we shall do an experiment to show that air is present all around us. For this you just need a pinwheel. You know a pinwheel, you must have played it in your childhood. Take a pinwheel and hold it in your hand and run back and forward. You will see the blades of the pinwheel also starts moving back and forward, and when you will run fast, the pinwheel will rotate fast. When you will run slow, the pinwheel will rotate, the blades of the pinwheel will rotate slow. The blades of the pinwheel move due to the presence of air. So this shows that air is present all around us. Now second thing about air is that air is a matter, so air occupies space also. How can we show that air occupies space? For this we will need all, we can do a small experiment. We need a glass vessel, a empty glass. First you invert an empty glass straight into a vessel full of water. You see that the water cannot enter the empty glass. Then you tilt the glass a little and see that the water starts entering the glass. What happened? Why was first water not entering and now the water has started entering the glass? When you actually the glass which you were thinking that is empty was not at all empty. It was full of air. When you inverted the glass straight into the water vessel, there was no space since it was full of air, so water could not enter. There was no space for water. But when you tilted the glass, some of the air escaped. You can see bubbles in the form of bubbles. You can see that the some of the air escaped, and then the space was created and water started entering the glass. This shows that air occupies space. As I am telling you, air is all around us. So the blanket of air that surrounds the earth is called atmosphere. This atmosphere extends to a height of 300 kilometers above the earth. There are several layers in the atmosphere which is not in your course, like troposphere, stratosphere, mesosphere, thermosphere, exosphere. We live in the troposphere. Layers of the atmosphere is not in your course. I am telling you just for an information. Now the composition of air. Air is not made up of a single type of thing. It is a mixture. A mixture of what? A mixture of gases, which was proved by a scientist called Lavoisier, that air is a mixture of gases. The major gases in the air are nitrogen, oxygen, carbon dioxide, and some other gases like argon. Besides gases, the air also contains water vapor and smoke, dust and smoke. Now let us discuss the components of air. First is nitrogen. Nitrogen is present in, see this, nitrogen is present in 78%, means 3/4 of the earth. But it is the maximum amount of gas in air. Nitrogen neither supports burning nor it burns. Next is oxygen, which is very useful for all living beings for breathing, and also used by all living things for breathing. Yes, and it also is used for burning. Oxygen supports burning. and it is in 21 in percentage, means 1/4 of the air nearly. And as we go up, the amount of oxygen decreases. The next is carbon dioxide, which is present in very small amount, about 0.3%. Beside these gases, there are carbon dioxide is used by photosynthesis, by plants for photosynthesis. Beside these gases, air contains water vapor, dust and smoke. The amount of water vapor present in the air is called as humidity. Now we shall discuss an activity to prove that air contains oxygen. You know that oxygen supports burning. So what you have to do, just take a lighted candle and cover it with a glass. After some time you see that the candle stops burning. Why does the candle stop burning? Because when you cover the candle with a glass, the amount of air also restricted to enter the glass, and air contains oxygen. Since there was no oxygen inside the glass, the candle stopped burning. This activity shows that air contains oxygen. Then how is oxygen and carbon dioxide balanced in nature? Oxygen is 21%, carbon dioxide is only 0.3%. How are these gases balanced in nature? Oxygen is used by breathing, you know, by every living thing. They take in oxygen gas and release carbon dioxide gas. And by burning of fuel also carbon dioxide gas is produced. And oxygen is used. So, when the living things take oxygen for breathing, they give out carbon dioxide gas. This carbon dioxide gas is used by green plants for making of their food in presence of sunlight. And carbon dioxide and water, the plants prepare their food by the process of photosynthesis. And in the process of photosynthesis, oxygen is released. This oxygen is again taken by the green by all living things for breathing, and again they give out carbon dioxide. Again carbon dioxide is taken by the green plants for making their food. This is how balance of carbon dioxide and oxygen is maintained in nature. Next is the uses of air. Air is very useful for us. You know, can you tell me the various uses of air? Air is used by all living things for respiration. Then air is used for burning of fuels. Air is used to fly kites, to fly parachutes and gliders. Moving air also helps the sailing boats to move. It is used to turn the blades of the windmills. Air is used for drying clothes, drying our hairs also. Air is also used for maintain the water cycle on earth. So, air is very useful for us. Air is also a medium for sound to propagate. So, these are the various uses of air. Now, you revise this chapter and prepare for your test, and please give your test honestly and seriously. Take it very seriously. Don't think that it is only a formality. Okay?